Electric Performance Lounge with the EQS AMG. We put it to the Sports Plus mode. Sport and Sport Plus mode offer launch control. Hitting the brakes with the left foot. Throttle with the right foot. And let's go. Plop. That was 60 miles. Reducing to 55 once again. Whoa. Woo. Yeah, and that was even slightly uphill. Thomas P is also laughing. The very first all-electric AMG model, the Mercedes AMG EQS 53. All electric and therefore also the closed front grille, but with the typical AMG design, vertical fins right there. This one is still three-dimensional here, sensor hidden behind it and the front camera. Lower part here with a contrasting spoiler, so a more aggressive look. But definitely still this very seamless design for the EQS, all set on aerodynamics. The light strip goes all the way across the front of the vehicle and the digital light is on board here. This is an option. You start with a normal LED. And what we can also see here, you get bigger wheels, 21-inch or 22-inch. And these here are the biggest ones available, 22-inch. Overlapping design here in the front, this is the characteristic thing, and you cannot open the hood. There is no frunk. What's underneath it is actually the big HEPA filter, if you went for that optional. The only thing you can open is here the wiper fluid box. It looks kind of weird, doesn't it? Yeah, funny thing. So when you want to show off something to your friends, maybe that it is. As for colors, our main vehicle, Hyacinth Red, but we also have today for you the Graphite Grey, a dark grey, then the bright high-tech silver, and the famous Selenite Grey Magno, a very popular Mercedes color because this one has this matte paint effect, always a looker as well. This length here is 5 meters 22 or 206 inches, so indeed massive as for the length. But of course, the same as the normal EQS. The difference is the acceleration figure, where the EQS 580, the all-wheel drive model, has an acceleration figure of 4.3 seconds. This one here goes 3.4 seconds to 100 kilometers or 62 miles an hour, of course, very impressive. Top speed, 250 kilometers an hour or 155 miles an hour. In the side profile, you can once again see this one bow design here from that A-pillar going all the way across the rear. And that also, once again, makes it so aerodynamic. Strong shoulder area right here. This is also a very central part of the vehicle. And then we have the black frames around the windows to make it a little bit sportier. The wheels, maybe you've already seen it, have this aerodynamic design. And in the Dynamic Plus package, you get bigger brakes, for example, and the air suspension, which is standard, has a stiffer setup. Option, you can also get the carbon ceramic brakes. In the rear, once again, the design with the light strip going all the way across the vehicle and a seamless design. Here we have this wing for a little bit more downforce. Well, and then as for technology, the rear wheels can turn up to 9 degrees in the opposite direction than the front wheels. This rear axle seam is really massive. At higher speeds, it goes parallel, but at lower speeds, you have just more agility, kind of faking a shorter wheelbase. In the lower part, this special bumper here is because, you know, it's the American spec here with a small number plate. It will look different from market to market. Once again, the contrasting black lower bumper in this diffuser style right here. As for battery and range, this one only gets the bigger battery of the EQS. That means 108 kilowatt hours. That's, of course, a massive capacity. The range figure, we tested it with the EQS 580, and you can score similar figures with that. When you drive really efficient, you can get over 600 kilometers or a little bit less than 400 miles. That is actually possible. Of course, here probably will use the power output. It will be a little bit less. Soon, check out how it will be in our today's driving test. As for recharging, 11 or 22 kilowatt AC or then 200 kilowatt DC. And in ideal conditions, 10 to 80% state of charge is then done in 30 minutes. This is the car key here with an AMG badge at the side. Then when you open the vehicle or approach it, the door handles fold out. There's also an automatic door opening and closing function available, by the way. So door closing sound. is not good at all because also frameless. And here, however, we have the soft close feature like this. And you can see when you close it manually, then there are these motors then inside the doors, and that's why it's kind of weird to open it manually. What's cool here, new materials at the inside of the doors. It's kind of like a neoprene style material here as well. That's really nice. Here, capacitive BS. This is like one button here, just one button then for seat heating, seat cooling, and the gentleman's function that you can control the passenger seat here. And what's also interesting here, as for sound deadening, here in the top part, you can see we have the dual insulation glass. As for seats, this is the so-called comfort seat, only available with animal skin. However, there's also the sports seat, which would be the standard seat for all markets. And in Europe, we get it with Dynamica microfiber on the inside, Artico leatherette on the outside. For the US market, they decided to go for the sports seat with animal skin only as well. So that means that the flagship for their sustainable luxury brand slogan at Mercedes, the flagship car for that, is not available animal-free in the US market especially. What is this? Then you have to go back to the normal EQS. There you have more animal-free options. And here on the steering wheel, you can at least get the Dynamica microfiber here at the side. But once again, only an option, so disappointing as for the material choices in the EQS AMG. The seating position here in the front, by the way, is actually quite comfortable. However, with the panoramic roof, it gets really close with 1m86 or 6'1". But for me, it's fine. If you're taller, it might be a problem. But the coolest thing here is, yeah, that's microfiber. This very soft cushion here in the front. That's good and relaxing. Interior overview, you can see here, nice with the ambient lighting. There's also a special feature available that the ambient lighting changes according to the driving input at night. We also have a special episode of that, of the EQS 580, really impressive. Here, of course, obviously, the so-called hyper screen, which would be an option for the normal EQS. And then you would have like this vertical screen as standard, like in the S-Class or C-Class. Here, this hyper screen is standard for the EQS AMG. That means it's kind of like a one area, but then you can see split, one main screen here, then an optional passenger screen, but it's included then here in that hyper screen. And on the left side, the digital instruments. Steering wheel here, AMG style with two spokes there, and then hashtag capacitive BS buttons here on the steering wheel. This is then for the right screen, left side is for the left screen. And yeah, you can control it here with the volume and stuff, left side cruise control. It is still harder to control it than with real buttons. And here in the lower part, carbon fiber cover, that's cool. So it's less black piano use. Slide open, then you have inductive charging pad for your phone. You can just connect with the cable, both works. And here we also have these cup holes. You can also take out that whole thing, by the way, or you can have them it in an adaptive way. Then, oh, no. Yeah, that's tricky here when we have the cable right there. There we go. Then start stop is here, another volume control, but this is also once again one single button here, the whole thing. Then once again this nice neoprene like cover, and here slide open, typical split opening with chargers and space. On the steering wheel here in the lower part, you can change individual settings. Here this is for example for changing the sound, the electric sound on the interior. On the right side here, this is for the driving modes, practical thing to do right here. In sport and sport plus mode, you can also use a launch control, hitting the brake and hitting the throttle, but watch out, this goes really fast. And when you switch it here, it also changes all the other parameters. You can see it on the infotainment screen that it changes then suspension, drive, and also that the sound profile. And the display is very interesting because you can see it's kind of like a mirror of the digital instruments. By the way, here the screen, you can see it's more like, you know, like this. And when it would be more upright like this, I think you would have less glare. The same also accounts here for the instruments. They are like this. And this collects a lot of reflections and so on. So more upright style of the screens would help with visibility, I think. Then general overview here, general overview from the infotainment system here. Big map, but it's actually, considering the size, still somewhat responsive. Good overview here, center again. The temperature control always remains like this, has also this really nice effect when you change the temperature, really cool. And you can also change with the voice input, for example. And here, this is the main menu. Let's take a look at the settings right here. For example, we have light settings where you can also change a lot of things here from the ambient lighting. Yeah, sometimes it takes a while. This is in here, for example, like this, different. Oh, Malibu Sunset. This is maybe then the fitting one for the US, where we are at the moment near Palm Springs. So sometimes it's a little bit complicated to control this infotainment screen, especially while driving. Apple CarPlay integration looks like this. Android Auto, of course, also available both with wire and wireless. And let's listen to that sound with the Burmester sound system. And this has a really great in-depth three-dimensional sound like that. As for the rear, take a look. We have the same interesting neoprene-like animal-free material at the inside of the doors. Very clean setup as well. And then when you have this comfort package, you also have the comfort seats then in the rear. And this is also interesting because we have, and that's why I'm getting here in here now, here. We can fold down the middle part, and then you have this kind of executive area where you have this this pad here, for example. You have some more space here with an inductive charging pad. And then here you can actually take out this small iPad here as well. And as for the legroom behind the seat I'm driving, you see I have enough space. However, this car is 5m22 or 206 inches. So considering the length, not that well used for the space, and also the rear seating position is, you cannot compare it and say like, this is like an electric S-Class executive seating wise in the rear, because I'm not sure if you see it on camera, but the seating position here in the rear, I'm sitting quite high, the knees are bent here. It's really not that comfortable here in the rear. Headroom wise, works for my size, but also gets close. And from here, you can also take a look once again at this panoramic roof, which is kind of split here, one in the front, one in the back. As for the trunk, here you flip the logo. There's also the camera hidden underneath, by the way. And then this is the cool thing also, if you compare like the combustion engine S-Class, here this wide opening fastback style. The length here of the trunk is 1 meter 15 or 45 inches, so that's actually really long. The width here is, yeah, a little bit less than a meter or 40 inches, and you can see here our luggage setup. You can very well use that trunk, and we have already folded the seats here, two-third, one-third split. So that's a very good advantage here. Welcome to Thomas's driving part. Electric performance lounge with the EQS AMG. We put it to the Sports Plus mode, Sport and Sport Plus mode of our launch control, hitting the brakes with the left foot, throttle with the right foot, and let's go. Plop, that was 60 miles, reducing to 55 once again. Whoa, woo! Yeah, and that was even slightly uphill. Thomas P is also laughing. Yeah, you heard that when you used the launch control, it was like, so the car was building up the sound. You know, we know it like also from a Porsche launch control or something, when you have like, and the same thing they try to do now here with, yeah, and we're both laughing. So obviously, emotionally it worked. And you hear this difference when I'm here in the comfort mode. There's nothing. Sport mode. Sport plus, do you hear a difference here? Sport plus mode. In the comfort mode, it's off. But you can, for example, also deactivate it on purpose. Here, for example, when I'm Sport Plus mode, want to have like the stiffer air suspension setting, and then here, can deactivate it with my thumb. And that's the thing here, in the EQS 580, or also in the rear-wheel drive model, it's not that pronounced. But here, in the EQS AMG, they really worked on these sound profiles that are just more prominent. There's always the discussion. Some say, I don't want that at all, but you can deactivate it. At least on, you know, on demand, but it seems to be that the standard setting is still that it's basically always on when you are in this sports mode. And especially for passengers, it can also be good to have this sound feedback, because it more aligns the body with the G-forces, and you know what's coming, you know, the acceleration is coming. The steering is, by the way, feels very natural, so that's a really nice steering feeling.
Then we also have the rear axle steering, and that makes the car so much more agile, fakes this shorter wheelbase. So although it is a very long vehicle, center of gravity is low due to the battery pack, it feels very, very agile, especially going uphill. When you're going downhill, the weight plays a role and it pushes you out of the corners, but here going uphill, this effect is not that harsh, and it is really so much fun. So hardly ever you can have so much driving fun in a vehicle that is this long and this heavy. And that, once again, low center of gravity, natural steering feeling, and that rear axle steering doing a great job for that. The suspension, the air suspension, even when it's a little bit stiffer in the setup, and we are even stiffer in that Sport Plus mode, it still offers you a decent comfort. We have 22-inch wheels. You will have more comfort when you go for smaller 21-inch wheels, but still the comfort is very good. Let's go to the comfort mode here, compare a corner for that. Yes, the air suspension is softer then, so that is then more this, it's not the soft air carpet ride or something, as I call it sometimes, because it has this sportier setting already. But I think it's, you know, it has a very good balance. You can easily drive this car in a comfort mode and it's still sporty. And I mean, for this launch control effect and the acceleration, that's cool with the sound. But what about you guys, you know, hearing that now on camera, I would really think it gets annoying with the time, right? I also activate this energizing ambient lighting. I'm not sure if you can see it. It's quite bright outside at the moment. So this also changes according to when I'm, for example, here on the brakes, it stays like this. When I'm on the throttle, it has this animation. Yeah, we did show that in the EQS 580 during nighttime, and some also said, like, is this circus mode or something? So some say, that's just too much, but you don't have to use it. You can use it, but yeah, probably I would also long-term switch to just one unicolor style or something. Yeah, and here with the sound, I really think it's impressive to have that at some point. You can see also it turns red when I'm really on the accelerator pedal. Oh, there's a rainbow there. Really nice. So it is good for showing off to your friends, I would say, and say like, hey, my new car has this and this feature. But when you're on a longer road trip, probably you would say like, that's enough now, you know, I'm absolutely fine. And wow, that acceleration is so spontaneous and it is really so much quicker and so much more responsive than you would have with the internal combustion engines. So from a sporty driving fun here, also when you compare an S-Class AMG combustion engine, this one feels so much sportier, such a better response from that throttle. Great scenery, by the way, here, just, you know, close to Palm Springs. What a beautiful area. You should always visit Joshua Tree National Park, by the way, one of my favorite national parks here, California. Really, really beautiful. Well, I mean, driving-wise, really super impressive. At this point, we're going uphill. Then also the consumption goes up, also with the acceleration and so on. But later on, we'll go down it again. And this one has also very good recuperation features. Then we will, at the end of the driving part, tell you more about the really final consumption figure for today, and also as for the maximized range. As for the technology setup, one-legged motor in the front, one in the rear. What's the difference to the normal all-wheel drive setup in the EQS 580? Here in the EQS AMG, the rear electric motor has some hardware modifications. So I think you know that I just used a couple of more rounds around the electric motor, and it's a little bit wider as well. So little hardware changes, but it's the same base electric motor, some changes there, just to the rear one, not to the front one. And in general, the rear electric motor is stronger than the front one, and that means we also have that rear wheel bias. That's of course a good thing to have to give you some more agile driving fun, and we indeed feel that. At the same time, due to this dual electric motor setup, we can bring all the power to the ground. Wow. Really feels amazing, at the same time very comfortable, and that's the cool thing. So it can be a great road trip vehicle, and yes, even as an electric vehicle, because it's one of the vehicles with the highest electric range out there. But Yeah, I think sport mode would be maybe a good compromise. Some electric sound feedback. What do you think, Thomas, about this electric sound?
Oh, I like
nah, or yay?
this one.
Something in between.
Yeah, something in between, because I prefer the quiet driving.
Yeah, so Thomas B prefers the quiet driving. Yeah, and I think also, yeah, it's just better, you know. And then, I mean, when you want to have it sportier, suspension-wise, you can go to sports mode, then deactivate that that sound. So that's always possible. As for the user interface, that's definitely something to control something in the instruments while driving here with these slider buttons. Always hard to do. Infotainment system also not that intuitive. And sure, if you can see it on this camera at the moment here. Look at that, it's kind of ridiculous, right? It's like one, two, three screens, and then in here we have an all screens, we have the map now. I mean, this also shows it's kind of, it's infotainment system overload, isn't it? And especially while driving. So I would have appreciated if this car would be a little bit less tech overkill and a little bit more direct as for the user interface while driving. But sportiness, no doubt, very impressive, great driving. And here when we're going a little bit more straight, let me just show you that. Cruise control here set on the left side of the steering wheel. We also have this active lane keeping assist. Let's see how active it does keep us in the lane. Can we trust it even here on the non-motorway? Now it's, you see, that's too much. So rather meant to be driven on the motorway. Or when the corners are not that sharp. Here, for example, here now it's supposed to work. So I'm not steering, not steering. See here? Yeah, that's working well. Just when the corner, the bend gets too sharp, then we really have to, you know, not trust in the vehicle and do that ourselves. But overall, the assistance systems are also very sophisticated. There's also a blind spot monitor available, by the way. Oh, that's so funny. There's the mirror image of the outside speaker here is kind of like mirroring the speaker of the Baumeister sound system at the outside mirror. It looks like the speaker is on the outside. That would be cool, right? And so everyone on the outside could also hear our music. Yeah, or the electric sound. By the way, the electric sound on the outside up to 30 kilometers an hour, just that, you know, you hear that there's actually a vehicle approaching. Wow. By the way, one thing I forgot, here the shifting pedals. Shift down, then you have strong recuperation, that is then one pedal driving feeling. Shift up, normal recuperation, a little bit of regenerative braking, and once more, no recuperation, you're rolling. Of course, when you hit the brake pedal, the same recuperation happens until the real brakes are being used. And as for the final consumption, here it's good, but a little bit worse than last time with the EQS 580. Might also be rolling resistance of the roads here, I'm not sure. 33 kilowatt hours on 100 miles. That's about 20 kilowatt hours on 100 kilometers. That means the range here for today, around 330 miles or 540 kilometers. If you want to compare, by the way, the EQS 580, we have an extensive review of that one, so tune in there. And of course, we have the competitors, maybe also SUV-wise. The BMW iX has a great electric range, so tune into these videos.